All right. I got all my tools, got everything in front of me. Hi. This is General Tweak. And welcome to the joy of wargaming. You can see on our screen, we got two things. We're looking down at my desktop. Well, not really my desktop, a little table that I've got set up where I've got all my stuff. We're going to be working on two things today. We're going to be working on two Malifaux models that I've been commissioned to build by a friend of mine, Holy Daver, from last night. Remember? Of course not. And I got two boxes here. One with three Silurids that I got to build. And one that looks like some kind of gunslinger named Tuco. So, we're going to go ahead and we're going to start with our Silurids, of course, first, because why not? There's more of them. I guess you can also consider this an unboxing video. Let's see, of course, we've got our three little bases. And then we've got a whole bunch of parts here that doesn't explain where everything goes and which parts go to which. So, this is real modeling, I guess, if there is such a thing. Alright, so we got our three little things. Looks to me like everything's set up in a specific pattern for... We've got one guy and his legs and stuff. And his arms and all that crap, and then another guy, and then another guy, and then another guy. Okay, so let's see. In our back of the box here, one of them's supposed to be on top of a thing, so... Alright. I think I know where we're able to get started here. Go ahead and get rid of our little foam pad. Let's start on this side with this guy. First thing that we gotta do, as always, we're not going with the shears. We're gonna make sure our lines are nice. Or rather, our cuts are nice. That could have been a nicer cut. But still, doing a nice little things. Nice little cuts, nice little scrape. Just to get these things off of the sprue. And there we go, that part is loose. It's fine, and grab the other one. You know what, I'm not gonna go to that yet. Rocking motion back and forth just like that. Okay, that part's freed. Probably onto this part here now, which is easier. Alright. Now let's clean these things up. What we're looking for removing is any kind of little mold line. Anything that indicates that, hey, this thing is actually a plastic little model. Because the goal of this modeling, the goal of doing all of this, is to, well, you know, make it as realistic as looking as possible, even though these things aren't real at all in whatsoever manner. But you can still do that. So just remove the mold lines, get rid of the little hanging parts from where you chopped it from the sprue, that is. And just keep scraping. You know something? Hold on, I need music. There we go. And now we're back. Start of the dark. Anyway, where was I? Right. Streaming stuff off of this stuff. getting rid of all the little things, all the little tiny details. Well, not the tiny details, I mean all the little hanging crap and all the little mold lines that you can get. Don't want any of those things to show. Need this thing to look natural. As natural as an inanimate object can be. If I already made that joke. Yeah. It's totally fine. Totally cool. They really turned this song into vaporwave? I mean, why? Why? Oh well. Oh, because it's about sadness and crying and all that. No. Oh man, these models really do have a join line problem. If you look at that and how you can see there's just a bad line there, but anyway, let's get it together. Sucks when these things are clogged. And when you don't have anything to actually unplug it with. Give me a sec. Give me just one sec and I'll find it. So, the only thing I've got is a tiny little wire. No idea how far out that'll go to actually clean, but hey, it'll go in. At the very least. That's what she said. Or maybe, maybe not. Seriously, why the Christmas wave? Why Christmas Wave? Why? There we go. Big old chunk. That was actually a good, good beat match. Very nice, very nice. Stuff here go. Scraping off little things on a little tongue. Because why not? I mean, why not? Kind of thrilling, no, although unfortunately I can't lose a piece, because this isn't Warhammer where I can just kit bash or make something else fit. If I lose a piece, I lose a piece and it's gone forever, so I need to be extremely careful here, especially with all this tiny little crap, like this tiny little tongue. Now he's got his little tongue. Wonder. About as much as I can get off of that. So now let's try to assemble one. Let's see. About 26. Just a little bit. Got a head. Head in the face. Head in the face. Head in the face. Should have put that over there. Anyway, gotta deal with what we got. Move on to this little tail thing to play. For this, I will use our shears. These are faster. Taking off just those little bits as much as we can. Getting rid of the mold lines. Don't get rid of the mold lines, then it just looks like a toy. Which, I mean, it is technically a toy, but I mean, come on. Yeah. Mark, I'm not going to play Fallout. I'm doing Warhammer right now. Come on, look at this background. Look at everything that I set up, man. Come on. Come on, man. But you can have a conversation with me, of course. I'll probably play Fallout a little bit later whenever I can get a hold of Kostas. Or if he ever texts me, messages me. Okay, but yeah, these things seriously have a terrible join section down the middle of them. I definitely gotta work on that. Terrible. I'll play Fallout a little bit later. For you. Nah, you're not even watching anymore. Why do you care? Stuff that really weirds me out. Why would they make just a section within another part that's removable, or that rather should just already be on the damn model in the first place? I mean, really? Malifaux, these stuff is poorly designed. I'm not just saying that. I mean, you've got your bad seams, you got your bad seams on top of other parts. It's just ugh. I don't know. Then again, maybe I'm just being ruined by Warhammer? I really don't know. Now, normally I would be working on Warhammer stuff, but unfortunately I don't have anything Warhammer to work on right now that isn't just, Well, I have that Noise Marine. I could do that, but no, that's gonna be a special project. That's something that I'm still planning on figuring out how to do. What I want to do for it. This, however, this will... Since this is a commission, this can be done now. Plus, I think the guy's been waiting for it for about a week, so, yeah. Today, we're just going to be doing the building. We'll go over painting later. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow. Or who knows? Okay, no, Dave, they're not notoriously difficult. They're not difficult in the sense that... They're not difficult in the sense that these are hard to build and put together. I can easily figure out where each one of these parts and stuff goes, but what makes this troubling, what makes this bad, what makes these bad models and not the bad modeler is the fact that there's just all these spots for these little, as you can see, I'm not even sure if you can even see that, but basically it's a line in the middle of the dang model itself. And there's no real way to fill that hole or to fill that gap. Unless you're gonna go over it like I am doing now, then that's how you fill that gap. Where's the distance? Maybe it's because they're all rounded instead of flattened. Either way, they're just, ugh, they're not good. And you're welcome, Dave. You're very welcome, Holy Daver.
What's the party line? You can just follow up and talk to several different people at the same time. It's a lot of fun and a great way to meet new people.
Bye, girls. I've got a date.
See what happens when you call the party line? What are you waiting for? Call now and talk up to 2 hours on night.
See, Dave, you could be doing this yourself, man. But if you're watching me, well, I hope you're at least learning something and taking it home. I hope... Maybe I should... So that way you can see just a little bit better, because I tend to be... away from that. You can see I'm scraping where the lines are. In order to try to fill in those gaps and try to even out the surface just a little bit, so that way it looks just a little nicer, a little clearer, a little cleaner, instead of, you know, crazy. And there we go. Maybe Dave is right. Maybe they are notoriously hard miniatures. Maybe. Who knows? Fill that in with some liquid green stuff later. Man, vaporwave has gotten weird. Then again, it's always been weird. Oh, that's a bad join. Together. Swedish chef music. Why not? You got to. Make it fit, we're gonna have to oversaturate. This guy's got two legs, but I ain't got no arms, Lieutenant Dan. he's got an arm. Gotta be careful, because again, if I lose anything, I can't replace it. There's one. Lovely. Very lovely. Got one done. Let's move on. Went on to the second of three of these guys, and then I got that little gunslinger dude to do. Hi, Kelly. Good morning to you, too. So we're making our build, getting rid of mold lines. Covering everything up in dust, of course. And for that, that's why you make sure that you always have your tools. Need all your tools. That includes keeping a clean workstation. Thank you. Guy's body. We'll be right back. asking me to file for this one. So his body's put together. They split his mouth into three pieces? What the crap? Why would they do that? Why would you do that? Why would they do that? Dave was right. This is... these are bad. Oh, God. These are extremely difficult miniatures. Oh, man. What did I get myself into? Why, Dave? Why? It's like I feel like I gotta put together the head first, but then again, I can't put together the head because I can't... It's all right. We got this. Get all our head pieces. See what we're working with here. Okay, that'll be an odd looking join, but eh. That's how they designed it. Makes more sense. Just a little bit, not much. Now this little guy is ahead. Oh no, it's all good, it's all good. Everything, so long as everything's on the sprues, then it's easy to deal with. Don't want to look back on these after you've based them and find that one tiny little piece that you didn't accident, that you forgot to grab. Oh good, she's gone. Oh gosh, I do not like that person. It's alright. Bygones be bygones. Just exist. If you're watching, you're understanding, or asking yourself, hey, wait a minute, why haven't I glued any of these things to their little plastic round little mini bases yet? Well, because you have to paint those first. You gotta make them look nice. See? Gotta make them look good. So every part of this matters. You don't just wanna build it, plop it down on a little thing of nothing. Call it a day. No, no, no. You want this thing to look nice. Gotta look nice. Put the time and effort into it. I mean, come on, why not? now to build the rock he's climbing on. Of course, because why? Just why not? Just give him a frickin' rock. Something at my feet. Okay, so this isn't his rock. It's probably the rock for this guy. I join them, I want to get this tongue in there. Join them first, then we'll get the tongue in. There we go, his tongue is in. His tongue is in. Gotta be looking nice. Gotta make it look nice. Terrible join. Mm-hmm. Now onto his arms. And that's all three of them. And then just Tuco is left. That's those three. Done. Whew! Nothing left on the sprues. Oh yeah, this was, this little guy here. It's another commission. Also for Dave. He's got a little cigar, so I gave him a puff of smoke. Why not? Anyway, onto this gunslinger Tuco. And there we go. There we are. Okay, well, this looks easy. Looks can be deceiving. This guy's actually going to be pretty interesting to paint, aside from those, unlike those little, Silurids. Just a stand-in for the term Deep One from H.P. Lovecraft. This guy's just like some Western gunslinger vampire thing, probably. Yeah, I love saying Pepsi. We'll be right back. Look at the part of his hat with the horns coming out. Almost lost that tiny little piece. Just his little hand here, tiny little hand. A lot of these songs always have that. The kind of bass line to it. Why? And again, that's a kind of Florida ish, Miami ish kind of wave. And he's built. There we go. Oh, there we go. Oh. So we have our three guys, three little Silurids from Malifaux. Three little Silurids from Malifaux. And then we've also got our little Tuco from Malifaux. Oh boy. All brought to you by Weird Miniatures LLC. Hey, sponsor this. Yeah. Anyway. All right. That's time for now. I'm gonna let this stuff dry, and then maybe I'll come back and paint them later, if not today, maybe tomorrow. Maybe some other time. Something of that sort. Or maybe we'll get on, we'll play a game a little bit later at a different time. But I'm finished.